I'm honestly just sad that I really made an effort to do this side of my hair, and now the headphones are squishing it. Roll the intro music.
Ready?
Yep, let's go home.
Oh my god, we have a podcast. I'm screaming in the first couple episodes. It's like the first second and I'm already, I don't know what to do. That went really well, I think, right?
Maybe you're a little hot.
I don't, you like, huh?
Yes.
Like, huh?
Do you feel a little,
like screamy?
Yeah.
I was just excited. I'll relax.
No, just, do you feel a little hot right now?
I would love for you to define hot.
Too much fucking sound coming out of your microphone.
No, I think I sound great.
Okay, we'll keep it here.
I'm happy. I feel good about it. Hi, we have a podcast. I don't know what to do with myself, obviously, as my first 30 seconds went obviously really, really well. Our podcast is called Wild Till 9 because...
Oh, that's how that's going to work? You're just going to, when you get to the hard part of describing
things... Yeah, I'm going to pass it over to you.
You're going
to
say, well, let me tee this thing up for you. So Wild Till 9, you're going to love it. It's about... I want to hear your stab at it, and then I want to take a stab at it.
Okay. And then,
because if I start going off right about what it's about, I'm just mansplaining right off the bat.
Mansplaining?
Yeah.
We love a mansplainer.
We don't.
We don't. We really don't love a mansplainer. Okay. Wild Till 9 is a podcast hosted by myself, Lauren, Lord DIY, and also my... trying to find the right words to describe you. My boyfriend. We'll just stick to boyfriend. We'll keep it basic right now. Jeremy Lewis. And basically, we're wild. We're like pretty wild, I'd say. Like, we're like, you know, just wilding out. We're wild, but only until 9 p.m.
So, Wild and Out's taken. So, that one we can't use.
But that's not the name. So, the trademark people can't come for us there.
Right, right.
Wild Till 9. We own that now.
Patent,
almost.
Patent pending.
Patent pending.
Trademark pending. Nobody get any ideas in the next 2 weeks to decide. I'm going to start a business.
Yes.
Wild Till 9 ice cream. Hop on in.
Ooh, is that our next move in the franchise? Wild Till 9 ice cream?
Yes, and we've already done documentation for that too. So don't ideas.
Okay, so Wild Till 9 is going to be about our relationship and just the trials and tribulations of living with this monster. That's you.
Moose? Oh, okay, got it.
And also moose, and also a wild dog. So relationships, mental health, dating in LA, pop culture, sex, drugs, and rock and roll?
No. Not the last part.
Just sex and drugs?
Yeah. Yeah, we don't do rock and roll here.
We don't do rock and roll.
It's okay, the 2020s. What's funny is that every single person that, oh God, I've got this fuzz all over my jeans.
It's okay, I don't think it's in the shot.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
I didn't have fuzz in my jeans. Every person that I know, love, and respect, when I was like, yeah, we're starting a podcast, it's going to be fun. They're like, oh my God, tell me about it. And I'll have to admit that every single time that I was explaining this to someone that I know, love, and respect, I was like, I get halfway through and I go, maybe it's not for you. You know?
Why?
No. And it, you know, it's just because it's like an imposter syndrome. I'm like, no, you won't like it. It's whatever. But it is for them. It's for everybody.
What I'm hearing is that you...
Please analyze me within the first 5 minutes.
So what I'm hearing is that your colleagues and business people aren't going to enjoy Wild Till 9? I'm offended.
I hope to God, for the sake of my job security, that they do not enjoy this podcast.
Okay. I'm offended, I think.
No, it's okay. You know, I believe in a little bit of like, this is my personal life, mm-hmm. and this is my professional life.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not to say that there's not anything that's like off brand about it. It's just like, there's certain things that I feel like you and I talk about.
You don't want to tell your colleagues that we wipe our dog's ass every time he poops?
It's one of them.
I mean, I still think I'm offended, but it's fine. Wait, also, stop, drop, roll, and rate the podcast right now. Oh, yeah, that is a Smokey the Bear thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's Smokey the Bear. Stop, drop, roll, and rate the podcast appreciate...
But what? If you're on YouTube, you're not going to rate the podcast.
Okay, well, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, right? Is that how you podcast? I, like, don't even know. You subscribe and you rate and review, depending on what platform you're on.
No, depending on your thoughts, because you only review if you like us. If you don't like us, don't review.
Give us 5 stars.
You can delete it later if you don't feel the same way.
Yeah, totally. Absolutely. But I think you should go into it with a good attitude, and that means 5 stars.
Okay.
You feel good about that?
Deal.
Okay, great. Okay, so you're my boyfriend.
I am your boyfriend.
Mr. Lewis.
Mr. Lewis.
Mr. Jeremy Lewis. Also, yep. Guys, I just need everyone to know that, like, if Jeremy and I were to get married and my last name became Lewis, it would be an alliteration. And so we really want Jeremy to stick around because that sounds really good for me. Lauren Lewis, that sounds good.
Next topic.
Okay, but, like, tell the listeners, the viewers about yourself, because I feel like you've been a mystery, like, on my channel. Aside from just, like, you shoving your face in the vlog camera from time to time and the hair cutting video that we did on my main channel, mm-hmm. you've kind of been, like, a mystery person, and I feel like people
But I've kind of enjoyed, like, that.
Yeah, but now it's, like, this is, like, you are just out here now. Like, this is so, like...
Yeah, but for all, like, 17 people that know me that don't know you, you're the mystery, Lauren.
Right.
15 now.
15 now. Okay, got it. But no, like, give yourself a little.
Well, where would you like me to start?
I mean, I don't know. What did the people want to know?
They didn't ask for anything. That's the tough part.
That's the tough part. Yeah, no, yeah. That's actually not true. I feel like I get so many questions about, like, how we met, which we are going to dive into, because it's kind of like an interesting-ish, very millennial story that I feel like
a millennial story.
A millennial love story.
Okay, or a love story, yeah.
Millennial love story through apps.
Through apps, yeah. But you want me to be the precursor to that?
Do the precursor.
Okay, so born in the Midwest.
Oh, yeah, yeah, just knock them off, like a bullet point list.
Right, so born in the Midwest, called Rockford, Illinois.
We love that.
Rockford
is really cute.
Well, it's not. We don't have enough time.
Yeah, we won't dive in. That's for another episode.
Born in Rockford, Illinois. Uh-huh. Did a 19-year sentence there, and then... And by sentence there, I do just mean lived there.
I was going to say, I feel like you're maybe portraying the idea that you were in, like, county jail,
right, but
juvie.
If you've ever been to Winnebago County, you'd understand.
Okay, continue.
And that's not the name of the jail. I mean, that's just the general area.
Okay.
So I was there, and then I played all the sports, mm-hmm. and I played a lot of music, and mm-hmm. sang a lot. Mm-hmm. And the moment...
Jeremy has the voice of a Disney prince, spoiler alert. He never sings for me, and so he probably won't sing for you. But if there's enough pressure or a dollar amount on the line, we could convince him to potentially sing. So keep that in mind as you are a viewer and listener of this podcast.
I don't know what the dollar amount would be at this point, because now I feel like I go back and I'm like, oh, let me sing something. And I'm like, well, that's not how that used to sound.
Anyways, you were an all-around star athlete. Were you popular in high school?
It's not a star athlete.
Okay, I feel like if you played sports and you did, like, the arts, that makes you, like, really well-rounded.
I was well-rounded, but I think that I was growing up at the last few years of people, well, maybe, and it still goes on like this in the Midwest, but just like the people that played sports didn't want to hang out with people that were in music and vice versa. They both thought each other were just equally as incompetent and, like, not cool to hang out with.
Right.
So I think I had a lot of friends and a lot of crossover, and I feel like I was
always... So you were popular?
Whoa.
Were you hot in high school?
No.
Do you want to tell the people about your teeth?
Oh my God, you could land a plane. I'm telling you right now, if you looked at my face, you see where my eyes are?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
These two front teeth were an inch on either side, on the outside of my
eyes.
You
had a middle gap?
Yeah.
I thought you were missing a side tooth.
Right, but everything spreads to the side.
Okay, so which of my teeth would you be missing? Like, this one?
The one that's directly, this is a big digression, but yes, it's the one that's to the right of your middle.
Okay, so you had your two front teeth, like the two, okay, but the one next to it you were missing and you could land a plane through it. But you were also tall, and I feel like you hit puberty early. So you were cute aside from, like, the missing tooth in high school.
Yeah, but you know what? I attribute the missing tooth, I needed the missing tooth.
You needed it. It was a character builder.
It was a character builder. Yeah. You know, you can't have too much going for you. You need something to set you back a little bit.
Yeah.
And mine was my smile.
I mean, I know a lot of good looking people who have very just, like, bland personalities, and they needed that missing tooth.
Right. Right. Yeah. If they had just had terrible teeth growing up.
Right.
Then it would have all been better.
It shapes you.
It did.
It makes you better.
It did.
It makes you better.
It
okay,
did.
So you were popular in high school. You were hot aside from the missing tooth in high school.
I feel like you're really adding some color to this story that I'm not.
I'm just trying to summarize the main points.
You're adding some sex appeal to it, so I appreciate that.
Okay, yeah.
But I did everything from, like, play football to, mm-hmm. I mean, I quite literally was playing football and then would have to go play drums in the middle of the halftime show and then have to go back to playing football. Like, I did that in high school.
He's a star.
No, it's just... Who did you go to party with afterwards? Could be either side.
Okay, which had the better parties, the athletes or the art kids?
So, I mean, any given Friday, uh-huh. athletes would have more fun. They'd just be invited to more things and more just, like, social gatherings. But
Uh-oh.
It's like the band geeks, and for my band geek out there, you guys know, they throw the tent pole parties.
What's a tent pole party?
Tent pole event, right? They'd have the like their annual party, the Halloween party for like the band nerds.
Oh, like the seasonal ones. Yeah, okay.
There was some weird shit going on at like my band geek and my choir nerd parties. I'm telling you right now.
That sounds like an experience.
I think that I remember more about what happened at band and choir.
Is it like band camp? Like you see the movies Band Camp and stuff. Was your band parties like American Pie band camp?
In college, yeah.
Oh my God.
Shout out Stuart Stevens.
I'm scared. Okay, well, that's for another episode. Okay, so we dabbled in both sides of high school, and then what came after that?
I had such miserable grades in high school.
Okay, we love that.
That I had to go to, I had no choice, because I went and auditioned at like 9 schools, and on the music side, they like let me in, everything was great, but they're like, wow, your grades suck. When you have such terrible grades, they put you in on like academic probation, or you're like, you can come in, so you can't get any scholarships for anything.
Okay.
And like, we didn't have enough money for me to go to, you know, this conservatory of arts for $60,000 a year to go get a degree and whatever God. Else.
This is a whole other conversation, but Canadian versus American tuitions, it makes me want to vomit.
So I stayed back and went to a community college for a year.
Okay.
Also a great idea, because I got through all these miserable 100 and 200 level classes that like I had to take anyway, just knocked them out. And because there's no parties to go to when you're at community college because you're living in your mother's basement, then you actually did school. I like highly suggest to any and everybody who's considering it, just go to the cheapest possible option for the first year and just get it done.
That's good advice.
So then I went to school, University of Kentucky, which was
UK. Hang on. The Wildcats. Cats. Right?
A+.
Oh my God. And then you do it again. You do it again. You do it twice.
Yeah.
Oh my God. I'm such a good girlfriend. Yes.
Well, did that. Loved that. That was great. An experience that we could talk for many episodes about the differences between Northern Illinois and Lexington, Kentucky.
Where your love of whiskey was born.
Well, my love of whiskey was born, right. We put down the Captain Morgan and we picked up something else that wasn't so spine tingling.
Literally, I'm just like, whoa.
And then I came out to do a reality singing show with a acapella group that I was with in college.
Like, people, like, we're talking like Pitch Perfect, like the movie Pitch Perfect, where they go into acapella sing-offs and stuff like that. The show is literally called on NBC The Sing-Off.
Well, it was. Mark Burnett's not shipping that thing anymore.
Got it. So we're canceled now.
Yeah, listen. After my season, it got renewed. Okay. It's not my fault.
Okay, so you didn't personally cancel the show.
No. And so now we're here.
Okay.
Well, no, and to like cap the whole thing off, like, and when I was doing that, I remember specifically thinking, like, this is like my outlet of being creative. I enjoy it. I love it. It was fun. I worked and slept. I slept less in that 9-month period than any other time in my life. But I was like, I need to go to business. This is too much. It's all over the place. There's these like crazy talented people out here that were like 10 times as talented as anyone has ever met. And like, they couldn't pay their water bill. So I'm like, that, no.
Maybe not. Maybe we find something that's a little more on the higher income scale.
Right. So now I sell software.
Okay. Great.
And that wasn't necessarily because I like am mentally stimulated by software.
Yeah.
But it pays bills.
It does pay bills.
And looks like it's gonna continue to pay bills for quite some time.
I mean, one of Jeremy's like main attributes of like why I was down to date him was that because he was not a YouTuber. Interestingly enough, knew a lot about like the landscape and industry that I am in the YouTube world, but like was not a YouTuber, and that was very appealing.
Thank you. I prepared for that test for years, knowing that we would go on our first date.
Right, exactly. Like, our paths perfectly aligned. So glad you didn't become a YouTuber. Thank you.
A
perfect love millennial story. Okay, so let's dive into how we met. We crossed paths in business, actually. So you guys might remember, if you are familiar with my channel, when like parody music was like very much a thing. Like the Roast Yourselves, I did DIY Queen, which actually still... like I get a small check from every month, which is really nice because it's a terrible, terrible, highly entertaining, and like honestly a great music video, but the actual song itself is trash.
You looked hot.
I did look hot.
You looked hot.
Honestly, I watched that music video the other day with Asian Girl Squad, and truly I have gone so downhill from that point that it makes me really sad.
Okay, so for the 14 people on this podcast that don't know who Asian Girl Squad is.
My like girls, my squad of best friends, it's three of the girls, Mia, Remy, and Tiff. And so anyway, we went down.
Who are Asian?
Right. Well, actually, two are full Asian and Mia and I are both half Asian. So we make up a third full Asian person and I guess one white person. Right.
Well, and that name didn't roll off the tongue.
No. Yeah, right. So Asian Girl Squad sounded a little better.
Okay. Got it.
Anyways, so when I would upload these songs, there was a company called STEM for independent artists because I was an independent artist. And woo! Jeremy worked at STEM originally, and both in other relationships, I was dating my ex, and you were. You want to use the big E word?
No.
No.
Let's move on.
Okay. No E word. Got it. And Jeremy was my assigned contact. Person at STEM to
assigned contact person.
What was your title? I don't know. What was your title? It was
I was the manager of new business. My job was to quite literally go out and find if you had a massive digital following to go convert that individual to use that platform to distribute music and get paid for it.
That's exactly what I said.
Yes.
That's exactly what I said. So Jeremy was my contact person at STEM. And so my assistant was actually the one who is mostly in contact with you. Mm-hmm. But I vividly remember that we had a phone call when I was driving back from a hair appointment in my car. And I was like, this guy kind of has a hot voice. I don't know if I've actually ever told you that before.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I don't think I have.
You completely skipped that step. There were a lot of things you said. That was not one of them.
You were really nice. And you took the call because it was like a Saturday afternoon. And I was like, wow, this is like actually really good customer service from my business contact person at STEM. So we can thank STEM for initially introducing us and making you a familiar name because like 2 years later when we both found ourselves single. Wait, so what was step one? The step one was that you saw me on Raya. Celebrity dating app where you have to like be approved and referred to get into this app.
It's a messy experience.
So dumb. Yeah. It's so dumb. But like I think that we should dive into the world of dating apps after this because it's so interesting.
Fine.
So you saw me on Raya that I was single and you were like, ooh, she cute, she's single.
Well, because I distinctly remember the fact that you were not single as far as I was concerned.
Right.
And then I saw you and I was like, But no one ever actually matches on Raya.
No one matches on Raya. And that's the thing about the app.
I pulled Instagram and I was like, oh, she's posting thotty bikini pics. She's single.
I vividly remember the thotty bikini picture that I posted being like, this is kind of a thirst trap.
Trapped.
And it worked. I trapped a subject.
2 years later.
2 years later. Right. Here we are. So you slid into the DMs on Instagram.
Yeah. But of course, I didn't talk about like you or anything else.
Right.
It was Moose related.
It was Moose related, which is the way to my heart. Like before you even knew me, really, like that
before
was the
Before I
move.
Knew you.
Right.
I knew you.
Oh, God. I hate this.
No, but like, anyway, point is, yes, I was like, that's the end. And guess what happened, guys? Nothing. didn't hit back at all. Okay. Zero response.
So it went into, because I wasn't following you, and you probably weren't following me, realistically.
I wasn't, no.
Yeah, exactly. So because I wasn't following you, it got filtered into like the other messages folder.
But you know what's fucked up? I see how much effort and time you put into making sure that things are seen now.
Yeah.
I mean, you just sit there and just flip through talks and DMs and all the time or whatever.
Talks.
How is it possible that you didn't see.
So verified accounts now, and this is a recent update that they did, is that they filter the messages that have the most followers if you're not following them. So you have like your general slash like other category. And now Instagram actually filters the top messages to be from the top accounts that have the most followers. And before it was just like based on like when the message went in. And I should have been in my DMs because like I was newly single. So, and here's like another fun fact. When I was single, like when I became single, I was like, I wonder if there's like anyone that like thought I was cute while I was in a relationship that's going to like come out of the woodwork. Crickets. Like there was no one.
I was right there.
Just Jeremy from STEM came out of the woodwork, you know?
Jeremy from STEM, yeah.
Jeremy from STEM.
Right.
And you were Jeremy from STEM in my phone because I had your contact information actually saved. So anyways, a couple steps back, you were in the DMs. I missed it. Shout out Swizzy for down in the DMs. That's where that comes from. I feel like he coined that term from his series, Down in the DMs.
There's a song called Down in the DMs.
I think Swizzy actually did it first.
Really?
Like, they probably owe Swizzy money.
All right, fact check that.
Okay. Anyways, swing and a miss in the DMs. And then on Hinge, another dating app, which has kind of been known, I feel like, to be a higher quality.
Right. And I don't know why.
I think because it's more effort for the profile. Like, you have to add five photos. You have to answer three
like,
questions.
It's not like, hi, my name is X. I'd like to do this with you.
I mean, on Tinder, you can do the bare minimum. You can do nothing.
Right.
And so I think because Hinge was more effort, it was like more genuine connections.
Right.
Also, Tiff and Matt, one of our other friends, met on Hinge. Remy and Cal also met on Hinge.
Whoa. We're going to bleep this out, all right?
Yeah, Hinge. You want to hit us with a quick check or like a podcast
we
sponsor?
Could, we could talk about it, maybe more. It was okay. That experience was all right. It might have worked. Hinge by far.
Hinge, yeah.
Hunge was like 10x better than Bumble and Tinder and sure. League and Raya and all the other ones that I had premium accounts to.
I love that for you.
Next.
You know what? I paid for the premium accounts on Hinge, actually, because it... What?
Oh. I thought I was your first swipe.
Yes, absolutely.
Go back to what you were saying.
So I saw Jeremy on Hinge. And when I was like first kind of getting back into online dating and like dating in general... I looked for people that I had a mutual friend with or kind of knew. Like, I was too scared to go on a date with a random because I had done that a few times and it didn't go swimmingly. It wasn't, you know, the fairy tale of dating apps that I had imagined and had definitely been curious about.
And we'll go back to what you thought the fairy tale of dating apps was going to be, but right. Keep going.
Anyways, I saw Jeremy on Hinge and swiped right. And my dumbass, having zero game, we connected and I put into his message inbox, and I am still so very ashamed of this, "Hey, friend." How sexy. How flirty.
Hey, friend.
Hey, friend.
Right. It's not like Bumble where you have to reach out first, too.
Where you have to reach out. Yeah, like I didn't even have to do that. And I still... made a conscious decision to be like, "Hey, friend."
Like, there's a part of me that wants to just have never answered that.
Imagine.
And have you live with the fact that you started
that
with,
"Hey,
started friend."
With "Hey, friend."
Because
oh, my God.
I wasn't on Hinge for, yes.
Friendships.
Friend. How art thou?
Okay, so then do you want to follow up with your side of how that conversation went?
Oh, I was
went?
Drunk.
Because this is fun.
I was drunk when I got that message. I might even have like, been on another date. I don't know. I remember I was, like, out... doing something fun or whatever. And I was like, oh, yeah, I remember her. And
wait, how long did this message come after you had slid into my DMs?
Long enough where it was like, I almost assumed that thing wasn't even there anymore.
Right, that the door had
but
closed.
I don't think it had been 30 days.
Oh, interesting. Okay, I don't think I actually know the timeline of this.
We could probably look it up, but yeah, I don't know.
Okay.
Saw that you had hit me there. And I even think to a point where like I wasn't even like really on Hinge that much. So I remember I got the notification. I was like, oh, Hinge, who's on this? And I was like, oh, it's that one DIY queen girl.
Who made the bop.
Who made the bop. Who looked hot.
An artist, an independent artist.
I don't feel like that was... my first, second,
my standout feature.
No.
Okay. Anyway.
Anyway. And I remember I was a little drunk, a little bit.
Little drunkies.
And I got the note and I pride myself in at least trying and to put up a little bit of game.
Uh-huh.
And looking back on all of my attempts, that would not be in the top 100.
I'm more concerned with the fact that you had 100 other...
That's not the point.
...gameplays no. before me.
No, but the point point of the matter is I quite literally just hit back with like, hey, what's up? Something, 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 something. Let's just get together.
No, you gave me a day.
Oh,
you were like, what are you doing next Tuesday? I want to take you out for dinner.
Yeah,
and
I did
it was
do that.
Very forward.
And I distinctly remember... like not getting anything really back. And when I like, no, like I got a couple things back. And then when I was like, yo, next Tuesday, next Wednesday, whatever. Like I was like definitively like, let's go to dinner then.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when I didn't get anything back. But I was like, didn't think of any time. I woke up the next morning and I like looked at my phone. I was like, what is this? What imbecile?
What was the plan
what
here?
Who was spitting game at like half just so reckless and like just a whatever, and then also just like Tuesday 7:15 in Los Angeles, California, at this location. Like what was the tie between these two? No happy medium.
No happy medium.
Hey, spoiler alert, worked.
Right. Okay. So I feel like we're leaving out one little fun little part of that.
What part?
So about 12 hours later. So you probably sent that at like whatever, like 1 a.m. or something.
Oh, we can leave this part out.
No. It's fine. I think we should get into it. Yeah,
it's okay.
No, it's okay. It's okay.
It's okay. We can leave this part out. We can go on.
So maybe like 12 hours later, I get a second message on Hinge. I don't have my Hinge notifications on my phone. Cause I just feel like that's like not a good look if you're in like a meeting or something. You know what I mean? For like Hinge to pop up. Like it's fine. I'm just being overly paranoid. I'm sure no one would even see that and think anything of it because like online dating is like a very prevalent thing in millennial culture now. I feel like it's the only way to date generally. Like how would you meet someone if it wasn't through an app? I mean
oddly but truly because anymore it's almost like weird to go about it the normal way. I feel like that the amount of times that I hear that, like, oh, we just like we're like working in the same environment, then like we just started talking or whatever. Like,
that's unheard of.
Like we literally worked in the same environment.
And still.
Like I could have probably found your contact information.
You already had it, for sure.
Or I did, yeah, right. And like I still needed the introductory, hey friend.
Hey friend. I'm really proud of that. Hey. I would suggest everyone to slide into the DMs of their crushes with a hey friend and see how it goes.
You know, to be fair, no one else has ever received a hey friend. It's like creep.
True. That's true. Okay. So anyways, I didn't have my notifications on and I hadn't seen that Jeremy had messaged me and drunk Jeremy, I think, woke up the next morning and...
Well, no, drunk Jeremy didn't wake up the next morning. That's the problem. Drunk Jeremy went to sleep.
And then sober Jeremy woke up
and said, what in the hell was drunk Jeremy doing?
Right. So I didn't respond right away. And this motherfucking guy double messages, and I feel like that's just frowned upon in general, which is like, I think there's a stereotype around that doesn't need to be there, because I think it's fine to follow up, but because the notifications were not on, I didn't see, and then you put me in this position where I had to answer. You were kind of just like, well, fuck me, eh? Like, you're just not gonna respond, and like, okay, that's fine, like, no worries, like, catch you later. It wasn't that, but it was something along the lines of like, it made it so awkward that I hadn't replied because you insinuated that I had ignored the message when I just actually hadn't seen it. And so then I was like, it was like a weird place to be in.
I mean, this is quite literally what I do for a living.
Is
sell.
Sell.
Is sell.
When yourself?
What? Yeah.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, literally.
I mean, literally all I do, if I don't get an email back about something I'm trying to do, uh-huh. I will quite literally, I'll follow up at the bottom, will quite literally be something along the lines of, have you abandoned this idea? Are you no longer interested in this project?
Are you abandoning my dinner date idea?
I will literally end emails in, have you abandoned interest in this project?
That's such a big dick move.
Well, you know, it's software. No penises involved.
No penises involved.
Yeah.
Right.
But like, the point
hinge
is,
on the other hand.
But the point is, like, you literally will like, oh, like, I thought we were here.
Right.
And then you set the stage. You label that as a good thing. And then it's up to them to tell them.
Look how it went. Look where we are now. Everything worked out. We went from a big swing of dick energy of did you abandon the dinner date?
And just swinging a bit.
and then we went on a dinner date and it was really nice. Actually, Jeremy showed up. This was the best first date I'd ever been on. You showed up with a toy for Moose.
I did.
Because we had lots of Moose related conversations, you know, going back to the down in the DMs was Moose related. And so you showed up with a dog toy and mm-hmm. it was really sweet.
Fortunately for me, there was a dog store one block away from my place of
work.
Yeah,
but I didn't know that.
You didn't know that.
I didn't know that.
You didn't know that. And it was cute, too.
I mean, even still, that's a really cute. People usually don't bring a present on the first date.
No, and it then got me an invite back to your place
with the intention of showing Moose his new toy.
I didn't ask to come back.
I did invite you. Well, also, too, the restaurant that we had picked for our first date was, like, not far from my house. And I was like, do you want to
restaurant
give
that I picked.
That you picked.
Was
that
you three picked. Blocks away from your home.
Right.
Because, well, I want to see if we could just set things up successfully.
Oh, well, no, I wanted to make it.
Well, you live up in Timbuk fucking 2.
I don't live in Timbuk 2, but okay.
Okay, well, we live now in Timbuk
yeah.
fucking 2.
Yeah, so you live here now, too.
No, but, like, I just wanted to make sure
oh
it was convenient.
Oh, my God, I never even thought about that. Me being a homebody and, like, liking to stay close to home, I was like, oh, that's so considerate that he picked a place near me, like, on my side of,
Timbuktu.
Like, Los Angeles. Now, I know, you were just like, well, it's pretty convenient to be close to home in case things go really well.
No, well, the point is, I was ready to just say, hey, it was great to meet you, uh-huh, hug it out uh-huh. and head out. And you were like, so did you like, want to come back to my place?
Is that how I said it?
You said, hey, no, if you wanted to come back to my place. I'm just a couple blocks. Yeah, I just look at my car. Yeah, I drove. So.
And we'll then the night ended with a really nice, polite cheek kiss. And like, I'm saying that as if I'm being sarcastic, but it genuinely ended in just a cheek kiss.
Because that was a power move.
I guess.
All right, because then you invited me over.
Yeah.
Toy was given.
I think I'm so naive, though, and, like, just hadn't been single in so long that, like, I genuinely was like, yeah, come give my dog this toy. Like, I wasn't like, yeah, come back to my house. Like, it wasn't like that.
Wait.
Yeah.
One more time?
No, that was a one-time thing.
For everybody else.
No, they could scroll back and just circle back on that little piece if they wanted to. But, like, my intentions were for you to give Moose his dog toy.
And I had that intention as well. And And that's what happened.
That is what happened. Right. So
that is what happened.
That actually is what happened.
Everyone's intentions were met.
I think we actually both deleted all of our dating apps after like our fourth date or something. You deleted yours first. Which apps did you have?
All of them.
Okay. Give us a list. Because I feel like you were on some that I wasn't even on.
Tinder, Bumble, Raya, Hinge, The League.
I want to talk about The League. That's the one that I was not on. But that was the next one that I was thinking. I remember even on our first date, you offered me a code.
I did.
If I wanted to get on The League.
I did. That's power move right there.
Yeah, how nice. Yeah. If it didn't go well with you, I could have went and hopped found on some other...
somebody else from the East Coast with a degree from Yale.
Right. Sure. Yeah.
Yeah, which is not what? My pedigree.
Okay, so rate them. Which did you have the most luck on? Obviously Hinge, because you found me.
Right.
I found you.
Nothing else matters, friend.
Right, friend. Love that.
I mean, I think they all serve a purpose.
Please do elaborate. Well,
and this is really more from field knowledge, because I have a lot of friends who are on them.
Right, right. Not personal experience.
Right. Because, like, for me, I'm not on J-Swipe.
Right.
No, I'm not
You're
Jewish.
You're not Jewish. Right.
Right.
Christian Mingle? Not, well.
Well.
I guess you could have been. Yeah,
that one.
I just don't think you would have. Okay, anyway. Okay, so for hooking up, which was number one?
Realistically, I think everyone would think Tinder.
Yeah.
But Tinder in LA has, I think, gone downhill so
definitely
far.
Tinder was so scary.
Right. So I think, honestly, it might have been Bumble.
On Bumble, I was always just like so relieved. Once I sent the message, the ball was just not in my court. You could literally send like an emoji or something and then you're allowed to talk to that person.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Was I the type that you wouldn't have responded to?
Yeah.
I just wanted to start the conversation so that the pressure was off me to like carry on the conversation. Again, I need you guys to know that I have zero game unless I am intoxicated. When I have a few drinks in me,
even when you are intoxicated,
it's not great, but it's endearing to some, I would say.
No, it's endearing, but game is not necessarily intended to be endearing.
I disagree. I think that I want to be endearing to my target. When I first got back into like the app scene, I was so picky. Again, like I mentioned, I was looking for people who I kind of knew. And I feel like the industry is so big that there was like, that was not like a crazy thing to have as a filter to be like, I'd love to find someone that I have a mutual friend with, because like, I feel like we kind of know a lot of people in LA. So I was like, that would be like so ideal. But I was picky. I was so picky on Hinge. Actually, this is so crazy. And I think they've actually gotten in trouble a little bit for this, but the filters that you can set on Hinge are like very specific.
Right.
And some of them are great. It's like, if you don't want someone that smokes or drinks, you can filter that out. And I think that's like, that's such a great idea. But like one that I use that I'm not proud of. Anyway, I was looking for a tall man. And so I put my height filter at 6 feet. Not to say that I could never love someone who's under 6 feet, but like.
Well, also someone could also lie.
I would say if a guy is 5'10", maybe even 5'9".
Six.
No, there's no 5'6", they say they're 5'10".
No.
In my experience.
No, I'm saying if they can remotely round up.
Oh, to 6?
They're rounding
to 6.
And by God, if I was 5'11", I'd be 6 foot.
6 foot, yeah, right. Of course, absolutely. So I set mine to 6 foot because I knew that that would catch me a net of guys between 5'10", maybe 5'9", and taller.
It would cast a net.
What did I say?
You wouldn't catch a net.
Well, I caught you in my net that I cast. Right. Okay.
Your target, I remember the word you used a moment ago.
Babe, you're my target.
Mm-hmm. Bullseye.
And I got you. Bullseye. Yeah. What do you mean? That's great.
Friend.
Hey, friend. But Bumble was okay. Hinge was the best. Tinder had...
Hinge is the best because I'm 6'4". That's the only reason that I think that all worked out
for
us.
Yeah, but you could do well on any app being 6'4". Girls love the idea of a tall guy.
Yeah, no one ever hit me with like a, ooh, 6'4"?
You're too tall.
Yikes.
I don't know.
Yikes.
Can't do it.
Yeah. No, I could land a plane between these teeth, but was
6'4".
Tall.
Right,
yeah, it was
right.
Tall.
Well, now you have a fake tooth.
Right, no, yeah, no.
Now you have a fake tooth.
Yeah, it's like my personality.
Tell me about The League, because that's the one that I never got onto because we ended up dating, but that would have been my next endeavor because I was like ready to find a successful man.
Right, so The League was very much tailored towards people with, I mean, The League was like LinkedIn transferred over to a dating experience.
That's so weird.
At least at the time. I don't know if it's like anymore, but like they pretend like they had this like massive, massive wait list. I don't know if it was true or not, but I remember it would quite literally say that it was like, You are number 30,436.
Oh my God.
In your area.
How to make someone feel so inferior. Like you're not rich enough for this app.
But then I also remember like the moment I got the notification and I don't know if I like found a way in.
Okay.
I feel like I didn't like get an invite. I feel like I got in or on the league.
Like the organic way?
Yeah. Because like I definitely got workarounds for like Raya and everything else.
Oh yeah. Same.
Why would you get it? There's no workaround for Raya. You're famous.
Even though I had a lot of followers, like I still had to submit three people that were already on
the. That's how everyone does it.
Oh, okay.
That's literally the way that it works.
Okay, well then that's how I got accepted.
Yeah, I did that and was sitting there on wait, and then I had to go figure out who codes the app.
So you literally did that also, but it took you.
I wasn't verified when I initially tried to get on Raya.
Oh, interesting. So then I applied with my three referrals who were also verified. Yeah. And then I got in.
I already did. And I don't think I got like a no, but I got nothing.
I see.
And so
they don't tell you. They like don't tell you that you're on a wait list. You just hear nothing, like right. Crickets.
So I hit my boy who hit a boy. And then I actually found the person who was like a little coder on the app and they got me in.
Oh my God. And then you found me. Thanks, coder man.
The league was very, very specific in the sense of the type of girl that was, at least that I was like a kind of matching with or whatever. It was like me and a bunch of like banking analysts from Goldman Sachs and like this, and like being in Los Angeles and New York, like the type of individuals that were on the league attracted a certain type of woman. And so it was very much like the conversations there were just like the flex of who worked at this tech company or who worked in that finance spot or this or that. So it was almost like there was no hooking up on the league or whatever, but it was like mentally masturbatory in terms of like your resume being flaunted. Like you would, like your description would be where you worked and the type of work you were doing and the people that you were working
with.
Where
you went to school.
Yeah,
stuff.
Exactly.
Yeah, okay.
Whereas like on Tinder and Bumble, it was like,
here's my cutest photo.
Yeah, but also like, this is my bikini photo. I like dogs and I like to party on the weekends. Which is not the case on the league.
On the league.
At least my experience.
Huh. So maybe I actually wouldn't have done well on the league because my...
I think that you would have done really well on any of them, my love.
Thanks, babe. My dating app was really cute. I had a mix of dog photos.
Oh, I know. I could tell you.
Photo shoot photos, selfies.
You were in that little squat position.
Yeah, with the yellow backgrounds.
Yeah.
Yeah, you comment on
that. I don't know what's going on in the photo, but I look really cute. Ah.
Was that my caption?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was something really.
Is that what I sounded like in your head when you read the caption?
Oh, it's me. I'm in a bikini.
Okay.
It's crazy.
I don't know if I love the voice that you've given me in your head.
It's my moose.
It's my moose.
It's my butt.
Oh, I said something about that I like naps on my dating profile.
Mm.
I don't know. I'm not good at
a visionary.
Dating. I have visionary.
No, you were pleasantly.
You thought I was going to be a loser. Actually, let's talk about this. You thought that I was going to be a big craft nerd loser when we went on our first date. And I remember the way that you worded the fact that you were surprised that I was like normal and cool and like. Normal was like kind of offensive.
I do distinctly remember I don't even know it was like the first conversation. If it might have been date number two, but like at some point in time, I remember thinking to myself, craft girl fucks.
Craft girl fucks. Okay. I love that for me. I mean, like that's like a, like that should be my Twitter bio.
It should be.
Yeah.
It can be now. Craft girl fucks. I think you just never know when you're going out to meet someone for the first time, because they're also going to put on their persona that they want you, that they think is most like, oh, okay, great. This is the person that I want to be for this new person, especially after you've been in a relationship for God knows how long.
Right.
And yours was, it felt organic and real. And
also because we had worked together, you kind of had a predisposition towards like what my personality was going to be.
You just, you know, we got along and we were a lot better. We just clicked a lot better than I think I anticipated.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's hard to put words around it.
Craft girl fucks is how the date ended.
That's not how date one ended. I think it was like date two.
Date two. Okay. So I won you over on date two.
And now we're dating.
And now we're here and we're in love and Lauren Lewis on the way.
What?
I just want everyone to know that my mastermind plan behind this is that this podcast becomes wildly successful. Jeremy gets super rich and then can afford a fat diamond for... my pointer finger that's not an engagement ring.
Let's go ahead and just thank all of our sponsors for this episode. Thank you. So this episode's sponsored by our bank accounts.
Our bank accounts. Mm-hmm. And the debt that we are now in after paying for the equipment to start this podcast.
Mm-hmm.
I love that. That's really fun.
Let's not forget legal fees.
Right. Legal fees, trademark fees, all mm-hmm. of that. So
LLC. Yeah.
LLC. Yep. Yeah. 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 But yeah, that's the goal. So if everyone wants to come together and make Jeremy rich.
I just want to also throw out there that even if that, let's say that, you know, I fell into a truckload of money tomorrow.
Yeah.
I think it'd be nice if we just, I don't want to go rushing into anything. I think it'd be nice if we just kind of like.
Gail is sitting at home listening to this. Gail is my mother. Being like, give me grandchildren.
Meanwhile, Donna, my mother, doesn't know we have a podcast and is like, oh, you just take your time. It's okay, sweetheart.
That's so nice, Donna.
Isn't that so nice?
That's so nice. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Gail is itching for grandchildren that are not four-legged and named Moose.
You're 26. I mean, you're almost 47.
I know. And
I'm 28, so everyone knows. I'm an Aquarius.
Big Aquarius energy.
I'm a big Aquarius energy.
I actually don't know that much about Aquarians.
That's bae.
What?
Bae. I'm bae.
Bae? Why
big
are you bae?
Big Aquarius energy.
Big Aquarius energy. Aw, bae.
I hate
you hate bae. You hate bae. It's actually Leo season now, so I need you to bow down and just like appreciate me this month. This is my birthday month.
Lauren, I bow down and appreciate you every
month.
Oh
my God. I hate you. Okay, anyways, let's talk about the inspiration behind this podcast. Because
yeah,
I
your
feel
queer
like,
was dwindling. And,
right, I was becoming irrelevant. And I was like, I should probably start telling like my sex stories now to sell myself. I'm kidding. No, but being real, I wanted to just
craft
be
girl fucks.
More candid. And I wanted to show people that craft girl fucks. No, I mean, yes, but in a more eloquent delivery.
Do you need me to preface this and then you take it from there?
Sure, yeah, go into it.
So you were doing your quarterly
mental breakdown quarterly,
it's like
for sure
fucking clockwork.
Yeah,
I mean
it really
you
is.
Are if there's been more than 3 months I'm worried because that volcano is building up pressure.
We're overdue.
Yeah, like right now we're kind of overdue.
No, I don't think so. That was remember a couple weeks ago.
Which time?
I don't know.
Anyway, point is yeah, little earthquakes every once in a while.
Tremors.
Yeah.
Oh, this was the Christmas mental
oh, yeah.
breakdown. This
oh, yeah.
was the Christmas one.
So
yeah.
we were at the Phoenix.
Oh my God. Yeah, you're right. You're
yeah.
right. Wow, good
old,
memory.
One of my old hotspots.
I'm sure and all the women who've been to the Phoenix with you would love to make a Facebook Wait, group and find each other.
No. didn't the bouncer like say what's up when we walked in?
Yeah, and he said he hadn't seen you in forever.
And
I was
like,
sir.
It's good to meet you.
I've never seen you before in my life.
So we walked in and we got a table and it was like a fun vibe or whatever. And you were sitting there talking about how life is over and you at the age of 26 had hit your peak and that was it.
Right.
Which was 6 weeks after the last time you had said that.
Right.
And we just like got on the top of conversation, not like a podcast, but like, how do you become more of yourself? And
right.
I was like, I feel as if you are a different person to me and the happier person to me than you are to the people that you're creating content for.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think that you're allowing yourself to be the person that you actually are to all of your fans. And I think that's stifling your creativity. And you were very much like, fuck.
That was, I think, exactly how the conversation went. And that was a big inspiration behind starting the vlog channel, because obviously with the podcast, it needed more ramp up time. And obviously there's like things to sort out. But the vlog channel was a big part of how I wanted to organically just have like a refresh and a restart and not like rebrand myself, but just like start slowly welcoming viewers who were my age to connect with me, because I had just been talking about, I don't know, not immature things, but just like I mentioned this in my last vlog, just like the bubble that I was in 2, 3, 4 years ago was very, very different than where I am now. And I feel like I hadn't made the change online that matched the change that was happening in my real life. And it was like something that was happening and transitioning over time. But starting the new vlog channel, just like fresh, zero subscribers, and also the podcast, which is a new platform to really be myself. And I think a big inspiration behind that too is seeing Remy and Alicia, who have the podcast Pretty Basic, just being so candid and open about their dating experiences and all their boy things. And I was like, I would love that and to do that for my own life. And I think.
And I'm your boy thing.
Right. Yeah, my boy things. Thing. Singular. It, boy thing.
I think if we could not retract, but if we just go back a few bars, it was boy things.
Right.
Before.
But I actually meant singular. Just one thing. You're my thing. My boo thing, babe. My boo thing.
Next topic.
Anyways. Yeah, I just want to talk about like regular ass shit. And I feel like the vlog channel has been so good for that too. But like, our conversations are very different than when I'm sitting by myself in a room, and I'm able to bounce things off you, and our conversations are just much better reflection of who I don't know. That wasn't more eloquent than me being like craft girl fucks.
Hey, you know, we all have our journey.
This is my journey. Welcome to my journey.
There's something about it, and it's like, God knows the world is not in another podcast. Like, there are way too many of them. But I think if, and this is a big if, and we'll know this by episode 2 when no one listens again.
Right.
If we are able to shed light on, like, our personal perspective, which I think is relatable enough to the fact that, like, we're both, like, Midwest. Well, Canadian.
I'm East.
You know, we have a lot of parts of our life that a lot of band geeks and a lot of choir nerds can relate to.
On your end.
Right. And who relates to you?
Well,
that's probably why episode 2 is going to suck. But anyway, and we now have a different perspective of these things.
For
and
sure.
If we can bring that to the table, then damn it, welcome along for the ride.
Love that.
And if you don't like it, 5 stars and then head on out.
And then head on out. But make sure, stop, drop, roll, and 5 stars.
Yes.
Stop, drop, roll, and rate. That was our thing. I hope Smokey is okay that we're using that. I think he would be.
I think it's public domain.
Yeah, I think it is too. So anyways, being real, talking about sex, drugs, and rock and roll.
You keep bringing that up as if we're going to talk about, like, could you name 2 rock artists ever?
The Rolling Stones, Black Sabbath.
Are you just naming t-shirts that you own?
Yes.
It felt that way.
Yeah, no. AC/DC.
That's another t-shirt that you own.
I don't know if I have an AC/DC
shirt. I'm positive you have one.
Maybe I do.
I asked you if you do 2
Thunderstruck.
So what's the argument here?
I don't know. Craft girl fucks. That's where we're at. So stimulating. This is a lean forward podcast.
Yeah, so back to what I was saying originally, I think this is something that, listen, you might not have a commute anymore. You
might not have a what?
A commute.
Commute. Oh.
Right. You might be studying at home as opposed to going to school, which sucks for a lot of reasons.
That's wild.
There's something here for you.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Between, like, the dog parenting, my mental health being unstable, Jeremy, what do you do again?
Judge.
Just judgment.
I really wish that we could give a better synopsis to this, but I got to be honest, our lives ever changing. So is the world.
Mm-hmm,
and we're just living it.
Yeah, just living it.
How often are we going to do this?
Once a week.
I think we could do it twice, but fine.
We'll see how the editing portion goes since I'm taking on the brunt of that.
Is there anything else we didn't cover?
I don't think so. I mean,
how can people find us, engage with us, and say things that are going to make it on this show? You know what we'll do?
What are we going
to do? You guys speak the way that you want to speak, and we'll try and go find it. And then we'll see what makes sense, and then we'll go from there.
Okay, yeah. Put it out there. We'll find it. We'll come find you. We'll come to you.
No, that's creepy.
I mean, not physically.
Right.
But we're in COVID. It's a pandemic,
don't
babe.
Put something on Weibo and make it like, oh, they didn't get us on.
Oh, yeah, not Reddit also. I don't know how to use Reddit.
Oh, don't sleep on Reddit.
I just don't know how to use it.
I've showed you some fun pages on Reddit.
Oh, my God. Well, that's for another podcast.
Okay, so hop on. What's your wiki feet?
Oh, I feel like you can't drag wiki feet into this in the last 2 minutes of the podcast.
All right, so on next week's episode.
Wiki
okay,
feet.
So no, we're not gonna do that. And not to mention, now your wiki feet traffic is gonna go through the roof.
I know.
Did you just scratch your face with the mic?
Yeah, I did.
That's 2 things we're not gonna do.
It just seemed it's like kind of abrasive.
Stop.
And it's
nope.
Nice.
Nope.
Anyways, we'd love feedback, honestly. Genuinely, we'd love as much feedback as you want to give.
As much positive feedback as you have.
Just not anything mean.
We're not
please.
In the place mentally and emotionally
right.
for you to be too mean or too hard on us.
Right. So stop, drop, roll, and rate. Positive feedback only. 5 stars. Put your feedback out into the world. We'll come find it unless it's on Reddit or Weibo. Okay, we're going to go. Thank you for listening. If you made it this far, let us know if you listened all the way to the very end. Stop, drop, roll, and rate.
But if you were
rate.
To screenshot your 5-star rating. We would be probably more likely to see that.
Absolutely.
And respond to that.
Absolutely.
But we're not incentivizing you, or we're not pressuring you. FTC guidelines of all sorts of things. We're not pressuring anybody to do that.
Oh my God.
But it would be pretty cool if you did it.
That would be really, really
It'd be
cool.
really nice.
It'd be really nice.
It'd be really sweet.
Yeah, we would appreciate that for sure. Okay, we're gonna go. Okay, bye.
Bye.